Those of the advertiser and do not necessarily represent those of WOAI and iHeartMedia.
Here you go. All I gotta do is this. Don't do that. Don't. Leave it all the way up.
I can't.
Yeah, I just turned it down.
That's good.
Welcome to the KM Builders Remodeling and Design Show. I'm Keith, along with Morgan.
Hello, everybody.
We are glad to be with you this Saturday, and we are taking your calls live at 737-1200. If you have anything you'd like to ask about remodeling, about the process, or even custom home buildings, which we also do, you know, you can call us live at 737-1200. There's another long-distance toll-free number of 1-800-383-WOAI, which makes sense. Again, that local number, since most of us don't need toll-free anymore, is 737-1200. And we're going to be talking today about, should you hire a custom home builder or a remodeler for your next remodeling project? And that may seem like a kind of a interesting question. Is there a difference? Well, yes, there is. And we're going to talk about the specifics of that. But again, you can call us live at 737-1200. Today's a good day to take questions and for us to give you the best answer we can give you.
Yes. And we also want to mention that we are live on Facebook and Instagram. So we are monitoring the questions there. And you can always message us with the question. And we can answer that on live or during the break.
That's right. And so Morgan watches that closely, and we appreciate all of y'all watching and viewing. And so let's get into our topic about home builders.
Uh-huh. Did you want to do the safe tip?
Oh, yes. Go ahead.
Well, this is a personal story because, as some of you may know, I just bought my first house, and we are remodeling our master bathroom. Well, when we remodeled the master bathroom, we found out that there was a leak in the secondary bathroom, and we found out that the reason is because, and this is where the safe tip comes in, there are certain things that you can DIY, and then there are certain things that you should leave to the pros. This is one of them. Replacing your drain in your tub seems like a very easy thing, but it costs thousands of dollars if it gets done wrong, and that's what we're having to deal with. Because it's very easy to strip that drain if you put it too tight, if you don't caulk it and seal it correctly, and it causes rust, and eventually, which is what's happened now, is rotted pretty much the bottom of the tub.
Yeah, it's just deteriorated.
Mm-hmm.
And what's interesting is that you don't know it's happening.
No, not until it's visible on the top, the rust, once it spreads there.
Mm-hmm. And so in this
remove the wall.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, that's it. That's what's going to happen. Unfortunately for y'all, this tub was seldom used.
Yes. So no extra damage besides the tub needing to be replaced was caused.
Right. Because, you know, we were tearing out the one that was being used, and so that one started being used, and unfortunately it was back to back.
Yep.
So you could see it when you took out the old one.
Yep.
Took out the remodeled one side, you could see the other.
Yep.
Little details, right?
Yes.
Little details, again, little details that make a big difference if it's not done correctly.
Mm-hmm.
It can cost a lot more money, too. If you're ready, we can go ahead and take our first caller. I believe that's Dan. Dan, if you're there, go ahead.
Yes. I'm planning on maybe closing in my garage to make it a new living area. And it's actually, what it is a three-car garage that is actually kind of open. I've got three openings, but they never were closed in. And what I do now, what I have is that problem is that on humid days, I get a lot of condensation on the floor. And is there anything that can be done to stop that condensation if I do close in that that area?
Yes, there's two things that are probably causing the condensation, but the main one is probably just going to be the relative humidity. And when you put an air conditioning system in there, it will remove that humidity. And a lot of times when you enclose a large garage, your home unit can't take it. So we highly recommend a little mini split. That's going to run you somewhere around $2,500 to $3,500 to install. And it can run more if you pick a really expensive unit, but it'll really do a nice job for somewhere around $3,000. And it will keep that perfectly climatized, and it will also remove humidity better than any unit on the market. The other good thing about that type of unit, Dan, is that it will not cost you much in electricity at all. It's barely going to, you're barely even going to notice a difference in your utility bill.
Okay, great. And one of the things I was going to ask too is, I think when they poured the slab, I've been here in this house 50 years. So when they poured the slab, I understand that maybe had not put a barrier, say, when they poured the concrete in the garage area. Would that big difference or effect?
Yes, that was the second reason I was going to mention. Normally, nowadays, they do pour them in garages, but in open patios that are not enclosed, carports and so forth, it's common to leave it undone. You're not going to be able to go back and fix that very easily. There are some additives to concrete, but the moisture is coming up from underneath in most cases. Now, because we don't usually live in an area that has such moist ground, it doesn't usually become an issue. Your air conditioner will probably take care of it. The one exception will be if you were to lay a floor covering over that, like you enclosed it and you laid floor covering over it, it can be an issue. There's enough moisture coming up that it could cause mildew, mold. And so if you're leaving it open and you're just going to walk on it on an open floor and go ahead and put the garage doors on it and put a little air conditioner in there, you're not going to probably have any issues. But that's maybe will not be true if you try to put it and make it a living area, put carpet or something like that over it.
Okay, yeah, I was planning on doing that. Would it be, if I poured maybe 2 or 3 more inches of concrete over that, is there some way I could insulate that so that moisture would not come through that?
Yeah, that is a possibility. We have to look at it and see if you've got the room for that. And I have not done that, so I would have to see what the specifications are. It has a lot to do with roughing up that concrete. The problem with putting just a plastic sheathing or something like that on it, it can prevent the bond of the next layer of concrete. So that would have to almost be an independently strong concrete over that, and that would probably work. It has a lot to do with the thickness and the strength of the new concrete that goes over it.
Okay. Would there be any advantage to maybe make it some kind of a, let's say, wrought iron or some kind of iron drilled holes in that, so that second core will hold?
That's exactly right. That's what you have to do. You have to reinforce the new concrete almost like it was independently strong, and then you're not depending on the bond to gain that strength on the previous one. So you've got the right idea. You must have researched this, and you're exactly right. It can be done, and it would have to get into the specifics of the thickness and the type of reinforcement. But yes, sir, you are correct.
Probably about 4 inches, 3 inches maybe.
Yeah, that's about right. About 3.5 is probably what you're going to need to get the minimum strength to make this independently strong. Again, your use will determine whether you need to go that far.
Yeah, it would be just kind of like a living area, not another large bedroom type of thing. So that's what we're planning on.
Well, great. I'd love to work with you on that project if you give me a chance to meet with you.
May give you a call on that.
All right. Thank you for calling the show. Our website is kmbuilders.com. Take care. All right. And we will take the other call right after our break. But we're going to be talking about our sponsor right now, the Maids, who clean all of our homes now, and they are the official cleaning service of KM Builders. Morgan, what can you tell us about them?
Well, you need to look them up at maids.com/211. And you can give them a call at 210-822-2526. And make sure you tell them that KM Builder sent you, and you will get $25 off your first clean. And just look them up at maids.com/211.
And we'll be right back to the KM Builders Remodeling and Design Show. And we'll take your call, Tamara, when we get back.
Thinking about life insurance?
Did you hear that background noise?
Yeah, I think. Can you go tell him? Sometimes that messes up and they...
The recording?
No, not the recording. It's just, I think there was a way that they had figured out how to do it.
Let me see. He doesn't know what he can do. He doesn't do anything. He doesn't know what to do, I guess. Mm-hmm. Sounds like PAGS to me.
Did you write that? I wrote that.
Oh, yes?
No, I don't remember writing that.
Oh. That's old.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Whoa.
What?
Normally I can hear it through here and it went away. That scared me. Normally I can hear it.
That's because you turned it way down.
No, I didn't.
Oh, you didn't touch it at all?
I touched it this much.
Oh.
See if you can hear it.
Well, it's all about how loud I put it on. If I have it on my ears, I turn it way down.
Okay, that's why. I didn't notice that you had it on your ears, I think. Man, we have a lot of callers.
That's good.
Okay, do you want me to do this before we get started?
Testimonial?
Yeah.
Maybe we'll do it after the get rid of the calls.
Okay.
Let me just do this and you skip it. Maybe we do it later?
Yeah, just until we get rid of the calls. So we don't have to do those.
Or we'll do it at the end if we get rid of the calls.
I always just save what I don't, you know, if it happens.
It's more important with the calls, I think.
Yeah. He just looks so much like Evan every time I see him. Oh. Do you want to talk to him?
What did you say? I'll check whenever. It was mainly noticeable when we were all live. I'll check.
Uh-oh.
Bit of snap in there.
Okay. Boy. That scared me. Now, Bosh.
I think I'm gonna cook some steaks tonight.
Nice.
Look at this guy.
That's your favorite guy.
What's he doing? Oh, that's not my guy.
Oh.
That's a reenactment. But I love those shows. I haven't been watching them.
Did you record them?
I need to watch it. Could You Survive? It's him?
Mm-hmm.
Need to record those shows.
Has your allergies been bad?
Just in the mornings. And then sometimes I'll get a headache if the mold is high.
Mm-hmm.
10 seconds, he said. reading all the health benefits of, well, we lost one of them.
Ooh, got it right.
There we go. Welcome back to the KM Builders Remodeling and Design Show, and now all of our songs have something to do with the home.
Yeah, we selected them last week. We're excited.
There's no song about Sweet Home Texas. So
just pretend.
That's right. But it is a good beat. Mm-hmm. And we are taking your calls live at 737-1200 while we discuss the subject of should I hire a home builder or remodeler for my next project. We're going to talk about the pros and cons of that, but we are loving to be able to talk to you live on the phone. So we'll go ahead and take our next caller. Tamara, thank you for holding on. How can I help you?
And he went to my roof and told me there's a leak in my roof, little leaks, not a lot. And then I had my cousin come over and paint my kitchen. It's my kitchen and my bathroom that I've noticed a difference. Thank you. And thank you.
Yeah, we can hear you fine. You said you noticed a difference after the paint.
So I had my cousin come by and paint my kitchen. And now I'm noticing there's a difference in the paint. The paint is starting to bubble up in a little bit in the corner. So I really don't know, do I fix my ceiling? Have someone check the attic and see if it's high water or anything.
Yeah, we need to check that attic and see what's going on. Usually if you're seeing any bubbling of paint, it comes from two situations, Tamara. One is that there is a current leak and it's making it stay wet, or it's just old moisture. And in a few cases, you'll just see that it's created a situation where it's just not sticking. Maybe it wasn't prepped well. And sometimes you get that with old homes that they just didn't prep it well. You put a good primer on it. If it doesn't have that good primer, it will repel the paint. And so it could be very minor, but you know, it's best to check that in the attic first and see what's going on. Usually what we do is we get in the attic, we look exactly where that's at and see if we can see any signs of water dripping directly above that. That's where you usually find it. And it's usually best to check it while it's raining, if you can, and see what's going on up there. But we could have a roof professional look at that, you know, if you know it's a roof leak. If not, it's you know, maybe something else. There's just a small service fee to get that done. You're breaking up a little bit, but I hope that helped you. And our number is 680-5626, 210-680-5626. And thank you for calling the show. And so just like that, you can give us a call at 737-1200. We'll be happy to answer calls. I'm sorry you broke off at the end there, Tamara, but thanks for calling the show. And I want to mention our sponsor, Elite Lighting Designs. Sean runs a tight company over there. He just does incredible job on lighting homes from the outside, both on the home and on the landscaping. So this is what makes a difference for you if you're wanting to take that next step with beautiful outside views of your home. Give them a call at 573-0594. 210-573-0594 or EliteLightingDesigns.com. And so you want to go ahead and do your client testimonial?
Yes. So this one was on Yelp and it just came in last week, and she says, absolutely thrilled with KM Builders. We had a large project, a total kitchen makeover and master bath remodel. Also took up carpeting and tile except in the bedrooms and installed luxury vinyl plank flooring. It was a long process, but the precision and attention to detail throughout were amazing. The initial extensive assessment was on December 31st, 2019. The entire team was professional. Courtney was my designer and was awesome. My greatest fear was making bad choices, expensive bad choices. No fear, if I strayed from the path, she subtly redirected. When we finally began work, it was last week. It was the last week in August 2020. Thanks, COVID. It went beyond all expectations. All of the tradesmen were great. I was at work the majority of the time, but felt like my home was safe. Communication was good. Any issues were quickly addressed. Kudos to all involved with the project, but special thanks to project managers Tony and Lewis. Lewis had to pick up the project near the end when Tony had surgery and smoothly took over. Painters Miguel and Erasmo, Rudy, Alvin, Rob, Dan, all the plumbers, tiling, and electricians were great too. 13 weeks later, mission accomplished. What I thought would be a nightmare experience was a mere inconvenience for a few weeks. Totally thrilled with my new house. Thank you to all who are involved with my project.
That is awesome. I have not seen that one. Where did you get that?
Yelp. I'm pretty sure I put it on our WhatsApp text, but...
I don't think so.
Oh, bad me.
I have not seen that one. When did we get it?
Just last week, I think.
Maybe I missed it, but that
is
incredible.
Okay, I'll make sure I put it.
Yeah, as you can tell, Morgan's reading direct quotes.
Yeah, it was awesome.
Yeah, that is awesome. So
I just copied and pasted.
So before we go to the news break, let's go ahead and take our next caller, Gabriel. How are you?
Hello, my name's Gabriel. I just had, I built a ramp for my parents, and I made it out of pressure treated lumber. I'm wondering what my next step is. Do I paint it? Do I seal it? Do I stain it? What do I do?
If everything else is good, yeah, I recommend staining, not painting. And the main reason is the paint will come off. The stain will go deep into the wood. The best stain I can recommend for you for a pressure treated lumber is the Ready Seal. It'll give it a dark color. It gets into the grain really good. It helps to moisturize the wood and seal it, and it'll make it last a lot longer and it prevents some of the cracking that occurs in treated lumber. Did you go with 1.5 inch treated or the 5/4 like 1 inch thick?
Well, there's different dimensions. A lot of it is 6 by 6 by 1. A lot of it is 1 inch. Yeah.
1 inch on the top. That's good. That's actually a more stable material than the 1.5 inch material, which I always recommend. So yeah, make sure that it has completely dried out. You need about a month for that to dry. And then it'll absorb this stain. You'll have to put several coats on it. But the good thing is you're going to find that it doesn't make mistakes when you put this on. It'll actually just, you will not have streaks or anything. Now, it's very runny, but it's very oily, and it does a lot of good for the lumber. But paint will not hold up really long. It'll have to be redone, and it'll be a lot more work. And unlike what most people think, Gabriel, paint doesn't do any good for the wood. It actually traps moisture in sometimes, and it can accelerate rot. So I do never recommend paint on a deck.
Okay. Okay. So let it dry out for a month or so, and then stain it with Ready Seal. You said I'm on the road, so I didn't write it down.
That is correct. Ready Seal. It's one word, and you can buy it at Home Depot or Lowe's.
Great. Does it come in different colors, or is it just that dark color you talked about?
Yes, it does come in different colors. You're going to have to go with a darker one to get it to look kind of medium toned. On treated lumber, does not accept the stain, does not get as dark. And you probably want it to look like a cedar or something like that. So you're going to go with like a walnut stain on that that's going to get it darker. Because it'll still have a little bit of that greenish tint in it, and don't go with a lighter color because it won't color it enough. But that's Ready Seal. Now, I'm not sure Lowe's has it, but I know Home Depot does.
All right. Thank you for your time.
You're welcome, Gabriel. Thanks for calling the show. And so we'll take your questions, too, when we get back from the news break at 737-1200. But I want to give you one more number before we go, and that's 210-927-3410, Frank's Paint and Body Shop. I'm bringing my Hellcat in next week to get the road Woo-hoo. Chips done on it. We just had the Lexus, a little repair done on it, and it was perfect. Frank's Paint and Body Shop. Call Frank Machaca at 927-3410, and we'll be right back to the KM Builders Remodeling and Design Show. This is the
a nice day to be outside working. It was coolish, but not cold.
Well, I'm hoping it doesn't get too cold. It's supposed to get up to 75, and I'm going to wash the Hellcat. I haven't washed it in months. You know why I'm going to wash the Hellcat and not the truck? The truck needs it even worse. But the truck is just such a big job.
It takes much longer.
Yeah, so that's tomorrow. I want to barbecue.
Is it going to be...
I don't want to work that hard.
Today?
Uh-huh.
Oh, nice.
I want to go home and pull it in the back and put some music on and start the grill around 5, start the grill.
If you did it on a Traeger, you could, smoke those steaks for an hour while you're grilling, while you're washing your car.
I don't like steaks on a Traeger as much.
Ugh.
I like them.
So juicy.
Oh, these are juicy too. Because they're seared. Searing the juices. We have a little feud going. She uses Traeger for everything. Did you do the fajitas on there too?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But that's what you thought. You saw the big difference between... Well, no, we were talking about Whole Foods versus H-E-B, and you thought the Whole Foods fajitas were a lot better.
Uh-huh.
But also, on a Traeger makes a difference, I think, too. Because fajita meat is typically a rougher, so it's a lot easier to eat when it's smoked.
Picky on meats. I'm really not.
Yeah, I know you're not.
I like a good New York strip.
We've been eating the New York strips a lot. We typically get ribeye. Mm-hmm. But Jared's been wanting to get bison because it doesn't have... Hey, they did it again.
Wow.
We'll have to find out. Because bison isn't as fatty.
Can you text him? Let him know what's happening again?
Yeah.
See, what's happening now, it's in the middle of the programming. It's not... It's not like at the tail end like I thought it was going to be.
Yeah, that's what I told him. In the middle of the commercial break, not at the top.
What did he just make there?
Pea lunch. Water?
He's probably making a... that looks like snow. Or is that fat? Oh, I bet that's fat. Yeah, it's fat. He put some fat around it.
So we have a collar. You see that, right? Okay.
What's he doing with that, though? Going to start a big fire? Well, that is a sharp... see how this guy is trying to survive? I wonder what he...
To watch Last Man Standing. Would really like that show.
What's it about? Dads?
Yes, with daughters. He only has daughters.
That's Ray Romano.
Ray Romano was not in it. Oh. It's the guy who's Tim Allen.
Tim Allen?
Yeah. Maybe Ray Romano was in an episode... I think he might have been in one.
I'm thinking of a different one.
And he said, well, crap. He's so funny.
What else did he say?
I told him several times, these are for your sponsors and Red Life. I'll tell him again.
We'll tell you if it works or not.
And he has a vlog. He works at Outdoor World, Bass Pro Shops.
In the show?
Yes. And his vlog is called Outdoor Man. Hey everybody, Outdoor Man here. It's so funny. And you just see him getting like, it's so sweet because as his daughters go through things, he starts seeing it through their perspective and he softens and changes and is like, hey, that's not a nice thing, you know?
Is that me?
Yeah. Because sometimes it's hard to understand unless you see it happening to someone.
It is hard to understand. I see them. The older I get, the more I see how limited we are in our perspective.
Mm-hmm.
And we really have to be hesitant to be so strong in our opinion about things, which is not my natural way.
Yeah, and like his daughter went to work for him, and she started a restaurant at Bass Pro Shops. You know how they have that restaurant now in Bass Pro Shops? I know.
It's amazing that they...
It has to be a lack of communication.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to tell him it's not Michael this time. His name is Jeremy, right? His name?
Huh?
What's his name? Oh, here's another song.
I don't know. Welcome to the KM Builders Remodeling and Design Show. I'm Keith, along with Morgan.
Woohoo! And we got our songs.
Yeah. Finally, right? Well, we are mentioning something else you can use on your home, and that is BioGreen. Still working on my home. Every few weeks, he goes out there and treats it, and we're going to have an incredible lawn in the spring. Can't wait till the spring. If you're wondering what your lawn will look like in the spring, then start now with BioGreen at BioGreenSA.com. Or if you'd like to call them, call them at 210-421-9522, 421-9522. Of course, all of our sponsors can be found by giving us a call at KM Builders, and that's look us up at KMBuilders.com. Okay, let's go ahead and take our first caller since they held on during the break. Roger, if you're there, we'd love to talk to you. How are you doing, Roger?
Hey, I'm doing good. How are you?
Great. Thank you for calling the show today. How can I help you?
Yeah, I had a question in regards to my foundation. I purchased my house in 2017 in the Castle Hills area. And when I purchased it, I noticed that there was a lot of cracks on the tile toward the front and even on my walls. And I questioned it, and even my inspector said I should get the foundation checked out. They said they checked it out, had an engineer come on, they said it was okay. And then probably about 8 months ago, I had a company come out and take a look at it, and they said my foundation's dropping at about 4 inches from the middle to the front of the house. And they were saying it was going to cost about $14,000 to $15,000, the company that specializes in the cable lock system. Is there something comparable to that, or is that about a right price for a foundation lift of about 3 to 4 inches?
Yeah, the price doesn't surprise me. It's and you're probably going to end up spending, in a range of, if you were to use 14,000 as a point, you're probably going to get bids that are from, 10 to 16,000, something like that, 10 to 17,000. And what's going to be more important than the price, obviously, is the method that you choose. The cable lock system is a bunch of individual piers that have a cable between them running together. That keeps them together theoretically, but what it doesn't do is guarantee that they'll always go in the ground straight. They can turn and they can angle. And the method that I would use if it were my house, Roger, would be to do drill piers. And that's where they drill down deep into the ground. It's a wider diameter pier, and it's all one pier. And they cannot turn, it cannot lean, it cannot curl, and it doesn't create the spongy effect that sometimes happens on these, where it stands up for a little while, and then after it's done later on, you get this settling again, and they say, okay, well, we'll come in and shim it, because that's your warranty. Well, in the meantime, your house has shifted again, and the tile is cracked again, and the sheetrock is cracked again. So although no foundation repair is absolutely completely 100% stable, I believe that the drilled piers is the most stable method. And that's the old time, tried and proven. Again, who you get to do it will make a difference.
Okay, great. Is that something you guys can help me out with as far as recommendations?
Yes, we can. That's AVCO. AVCO is the owner's Larry Villarreal, and it's a second generation house leveling company. And Morgan has the number here for you.
It is 210-418-1658.
Say it again.
210-418-1658.
And we know that you can trust Larry, and he will give you a straight up answer and tell you what really needs to be done. He will not overcharge you.
Okay, that's great. Yeah, sounds really good. I appreciate the information.
All right, thank you for calling the show. Let me know what happens. And just like that, you can call the show too at 737-1200 or 1-800-383-WOAI. Morgan, I want to hear about this trend.
So my what's trending is something that I've been seeing, and I've decided to do it in my own bathroom, and it is a shower ledge. So typically in the shower, you need a spot to put your shampoo bottles and conditioner and all of that stuff. So what do you typically see? A niche
or a shelf.
Mm-hmm. Or a shelf. Mm-hmm. Definitely, to me, shelves are, I think of them in corners.
Right.
And so those are a more traditional look. What I have been seeing is a ledge that goes the entire width of the shower.
It's like a half wall.
I called it a half wall when I was Googling it initially. And if you have any bigger shower, any beyond standardized shower that you're not going to miss that space, this is the modern, nicer, cleaner way to go. I'm putting my countertop as the
accent top piece.
Mm-hmm. So that way it's one piece.
Yeah.
And it's really, really waterproof, and I don't have to worry about grout there for the water pooling up, and it's just going to be a really accented, still look big, but it's very modern, and it almost disappears except for that top piece.
Which reminds me, I mean, I think that's a great one, and then you could put that countertop on a bench if you wanted a bench. Are we going to do a bench?
No.
Oh, I think we should. I think we should. We'll have to talk about that. I think you're going to regret it if you don't.
I'm going to put a stool in there.
Well, it's not the same thing.
Well.
We'll talk about it.
Okay.
I want to see, but whatever we do, it'll be beautiful. Morgan will find something cool and fresh and new. But we're talking today about whether you should pick a home builder or a remodeler for your next project.
Well, we haven't really gotten to talk about it yet, but that's okay.
But the reason we want to talk about it is because there is going to be a recession, you know, eventually. And that's when you're going to see the remodeling market stronger than the home building market. 100%. Right now, home building, because of its huge numbers and the huge amount of people that want to buy, is very, very strong, and so is the remodeling market. They tend to move together. But when the home building market drops, we find that remodeling stays stronger.
Mm-hmm.
It drops too, but not as bad.
Yeah.
So what happens then?
Well, we get an influx of competition.
Yeah. New competition, so to speak, that actually want to get into the remodeling now, is before they may have hated it and didn't want to do it, and now they all of a sudden want to be remodelers.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of people think, you know, let's talk about the pros and cons. One of them is that they know how to build big buildings. Mm-hmm. They have crews that can do that. But the thing is that they have that's not always what happens. It's not always a big project. A lot of these projects are smaller and they're in your house. So we're going to talk about how much care they have to take compared to what happens with the way that they're used to working. If they're not used to this, it's going to be a nightmare for you. So be aware that when they come into the market, they may not be as qualified as you might think just because they were home builders. They don't have their own crews 99% of the time. They're going to use all subcontractors who are not used to being in your home. People don't even like the way they treat their new homes, much less that they were living in. And I actually know that. I had a comment this week about that, how they hated the people that were working in their homes. They came to the house and they were peeing off the back porch.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah, and that was just the start of the stories they told me about it.
Ugh.
Yeah, we're going to talk more about what, you know, and that's you think that's an extreme example, but it's not. This is just illustrates the mentality that goes on in new home building versus, and this was a custom home. Mm. I'm not going to mention the name of it because it's just common with almost all builders, but and who sees that? How often are they there? They're there maybe 30 minutes to an hour a day, the homeowners. And in ours, with COVID, they're there 24 hours a day. Mm-hmm. While we're there, the entire 8 to 9 hours a day that we're there, the homeowner's there too. So that makes a huge difference. But we want to go ahead and mention our sponsor, Expel. I'm going to get that Hellcat fixed, and then we're putting Expel on it. But also on your residential windows, call Eric at 430-7712 to protect your windows from even from burglary. 210-430-7712, Expel San Antonio. We'll be right back to the KM Builders Remodeling and Design Show.
Remodeling can get you the home of your...
Tell him don't do it again.
I don't know if he's the one that controls the commercial.
He can stop it or not, but we'll find out.
Is he?
He says, yeah, there's another one. He goes, I thought that wasn't right. So now we got to start doing this ourselves and tell them to skip these. This lady had a fractured hip, and she's trying to survive. Solar water bottle fire. Look at this. Using it as a prism, I bet. Look. It's pretty cool, right? The stuff you can do.
Mm-hmm.
Look. See, now it's burning him.
Mm-hmm.
Amazing, right?
Mm-hmm.
This. He's so cool too. And he's gonna blow it, put it in there. The guys couldn't survive anything. Need to know how to do fire to keep warm and fire to signal people, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Why'd she put that in her mouth? It's certainly not keeping it dry if that's what she thought she was going to do. Welcome to the KM Builders Remodeling and Design Show. I'm Keith, along with Morgan.
Hello, everybody.
Thank you for joining us for our last segment. And you can call at 737-1200 if you have a last question you'd like to ask us. We are wanting to talk to you about the thing that's going to happen soon, and that is home builders getting into the remodeling business. Now, we love home builders, and I'm good friends with a lot of them. We even have an affiliation with them in our buying co-op. But they tend to only do large remodeling because they want the area free and clear of you. And, of course, even then, there's so many logistics that go into being on your property that you did not have to deal with when you were having your new home built. So a lot of them will call us and refer us because they don't want to mess with that and all the details. They know that there's a really high risk of upsetting a client with some of these things that can happen. One of the things you want to think about, too, is that a remodeling company like KM Builders is vested in their reputation and in the relationship with you for a very, very long time. So whether you have a small or a large project, we're going to be interested in taking care of you from here on out. Whereas a home builder may only want to do that project right now because he doesn't have enough work. Later on, when the home building market comes back, which it will, they're not going to want to be around, or they don't want to be messing with any warranty items on it either. Not to say that they would ignore you completely, but it's going to be tougher. And they know what I'm saying is true as well. It's tough to maintain these warranty items on something that you're not really prepared to do. And especially the remodeling process itself can really suffer in the neatness, the cleanliness, the daily communication that we give every morning by 7:30. The scheduling is so tight. And, you know, in home building, a lot of people don't realize how big the gaps are for maybe one trade and then another trade coming in. There may be a day or two, but it's such a big project and so much work going on, people don't notice it as much.
And what about delays?
That's what I mean. Yeah, those are delays. Mm-hmm. People not showing up. And that matters really big whenever the project is shrunk from a week project to a one-day project. And then you have those one-day gaps or two-day gaps or one-week gaps, mm-hmm. and it starts making a project two and three times longer while they're in your home.
Mm-hmm. That's the biggest thing, is these things, when you're doing a custom home or any type of home, building a home, you have another home to live in. So it's a much smaller inconvenience than when your home, your kitchen is being torn up and you have nowhere to
Or even in addition, you know, when they're building on and they're not protecting and the water comes in your home or the critters get in your attic or it looks unsafe or your children are in danger. Mm-hmm. All of these things, the parking is horrible. There's no restroom. I mean, they're smoking on your project. They're leaving lumber laying around, nails. So, well, this is how it
ruining
happens.
Ruining your garden.
This is how it happens on a regular job. You know, that's exactly what happens all the time. And so how are these people going to change just for you?
Yep.
It's just not happening. And, you know, and they don't have a large staff. They use all subcontractors. So they don't know, you know, any difference. This is another job for them. And they're looking to give a good tight price and get in and get out. And if there's a mess, if they tear up something on the way, well, that wasn't a part of our problem. And you can understand those subcontractors. They don't charge enough to do that. Mm-hmm. That's the way they view it. And they don't have to do this on the other job, so why should they have to do it now on yours? Yeah. And they're just not going to go into it with a customer-centric viewpoint. They're going to do it at production viewpoint only. Mm-hmm. And you've got to have both when you're in the remodeling business. So beware that when things start going down in the economy and housing starts to go down, that there's going to be a lot of custom builders or people who did homes that are going to enter into the remodeling market. But that doesn't mean that you want to go with that. And I mean, and it's easy to think, well, they built homes, so certainly they can remodel.
Because it seems like building is harder.
That's right. It does seem harder, but believe me, it is not.
Yep.
So look us up at KM Builders, and you will find us at kmbuilders.com, and we'll be glad to talk to you about your next remodeling project. There's a lot of companies who can build, a lot of companies that can design, but no one has designed the experience like KM Builders. And we are constantly improving that for your benefit. Please give us a call at 680-5626, 680-KM-CO, and join us at kmbuilders.com. And sign up for our newsletter at friends@kmbuilders.com. And we'll see you next week on the KM Builders Remodeling and Design Show. Have a great weekend, everybody.
The preceding show...
Take $3,000 off all remaining 2020 Mazda CX-5s or get 0% financing plus no payments for 90 days during North Park Mazda's 21 Startup Sale. Here's just one example.